The year was 1972. The place, a church in Los Angeles. And the event, the recording of a gospel album. Her dad, the Reverend C.L. Franklin, was on hand, and Mick Jagger of the Rolling Stones was in the audience.
She never really talked about it. She never really talked about, it wasn't until about 3 years ago that I even became aware that the film was exists.
Aretha, who died from pancreatic cancer in August of last year, would not allow the footage to be released. And now we know why, including problems syncing the sound and the film.
The movie was supposed to come out in collaboration with the album, but because there were technical issues with the movie, the album came out, but the movie did not.
The album became Aretha's biggest seller ever and was released again on vinyl last week.
Watching the film, I kept going back and reverting to thinking that it was at my grandfather's church. For some reason, I kept having to remind myself that this wasn't at his church because it felt so much like home.
The film is 87 minutes long, and her family says it's a gospel concert her fans the world over will appreciate, especially because it's a look back at a moment in history never before seen.
Aretha's about 29 years old. She's in the prime of her career. She's there to perform. She's not there for any other reasons.
The movie will be in theaters in a limited number of theaters on April 4th, then released widely on April 19th.
And coming up tonight on Action News, you're going to hear more from Aretha's family about the 46-year wait to bring this film to the public and news about an upcoming movie on Aretha's life. That's tonight on 7 Action News at 6. We'll see you then.